What's up, everybody? What's up, gamers? This is Quickie Nog on NoggTV, and we're playing Smackdown, Here Comes the Pain. What a great, just a great classic throwback game. The WWE game that, well, pretty much, I mean, I would assume is the vast majority favorite. That's, you know, whenever I hear about, you know, favorite WWE games, this one always comes up near the top. It's got the, you know, everything you want in a WWE game. Great roster. I mean, 2003 was a great year. It's realistic enough, but also enough of that arcadey feel where it's not like, you know, anyone can pick up and play it and have fun. But it's not just so simple it gets boring. I need to change the difficulty. I'm going to leave on normal. Let's see, what if there's normal, hard, and SmackDown. Actually, you know what? I don't know. Part of me is tempted to... If I put it on SmackDown, I'm not that good. I'm going to get my butt beat in. But I know normal, you might get a little bored. So we're going to start it out on... We're gonna start it out on hard, I guess. Just for a little added fun. And if I'm just not very good at the game and I can't win any match and I'm losing all of them, then, you know, then it's a little more... Okay, whatever. I might think about moving it down. Everything else looks like it's fine. I wanted to move the. I don't know if this one has the. Okay, so KO's on. Okay, yeah, all that looks good. Ring out count 10, ring out interference manual. Okay, sure. Match length. No, we don't want to limit on the matches. Fast. Yeah, for faster matches. Because there's, normally I'd just do normal, but for YouTube videos, it's like you want it to be pretty, pretty okay. No, we're just gonna go back. All right. I was trying to find when I guess I know on some of them like SmackDown versus Raw, that I played. There's two targeting types where you have to use the D-pad and then the analog stick, because the other one will taunt. Because I know at least here for the menu, it doesn't want you to use the, analog stick. So we are going to do a new season. We're doing a whole season on here. Yeah, that's fine. Okay, let's see. Champion, oh gosh, Wally, okay, no. Actually, I don't want to carry over that stuff. No, just completely new season. Yep. Create a stable. I don't know what I. Okay. Champion, Kurt Angle, World Heavyweight Champion, Triple H, of course. Tag team, WWE Tag Team Champion. This was on SmackDown. Shelton and Charlie Haas. World's greatest tag team. World Tag Team Champions. Bubba Ray Dudley and Devon Dudley, the Dudley Boys. Intercontinental Champion was Christian. U.S. Champ was Eddie Guerrero. Hardcore Champ, Rob Van Dam. And Cruiserweight Champ, Rey Mysterio. Got Brock, The Rock, Undertaker, Steve Austin, Goldberg, Chris Jericho, Booker T, Kane, that guy, Shawn Michaels, got Kevin Nash, Roddy Piper is a legend, so he's not on there by default, and I won't bother to add him. Ric Flair, Big Show, Scott Steiner, Big Papa Pump, Doctor of Thugonomics, John Cena. Look at this roster, it keeps going. Edge, Rhino, Matt Hardy, too bad we don't have Jeff Hardy, Randy Orton, Hurricane, Rikishi, A-Train, Lance Storm, Test, and Goldust, Rip Test. That looks like all of them. Oh, no. Rodney Mack, Tajiri, Batista, Steven Richards. We're going to move Waluigi. Chavo Guerrero, Sean O'Hare, Ultimo Dragon, Val Venus, Rico. Women's Champ was Jazz, Victoria's Secret. Did I really just say that? Trish Stratus, Stacy Keebler were the women's. Sable, Tori Wilson, and Lita. Those are all the female wrestlers, so all the divas. So it looks like we got that under control. Stables, Evolution. You know, this one was weird because you could only do, I think you could only do, like, if you wanted to come out separate, like, as a tag, you had to put them in combinations. So you had Triple H and Rick, Randy and Batista, Batista and Rick. Then you have all these trios combinations. So the first, like, seven stable slots are for Evolution. Then you got Greatest Tag Team, Dudley Boys, Big Show and A-Train, Los Guerreros, HBK and Nash, because they teamed up for, like, a month, maybe. Booker T and Goldust, Jericho and Christian, Team Extreme. I think it's not active because I don't know if you can have mixed tag teams in here. I guess you can, I don't know. Maybe it's because they're on different. No, they're both. I think because maybe Matt Hardy's on SmackDown. They have to be on the same brand. Okay. Yeah, Steiner and Keebler, Victoria and Steven Richards, Rodney Mack and Jazz. Yeah, because I think here, Sable's on SmackDown. I think Vince is on Raw. Kurt Angle and. I don't remember that being a tag team. Sean Hare and Al Piper. That's because, yeah, because those are legends. I don't remember that being a tag team, but whatever. We'll just continue. That's, yeah, you can change who's on what brand. But do I really want to? I mean, I was probably just going to, I was planning on just leaving it the same, so. Yeah, I mean, if you guys like it, this is a game that I'm honestly open to doing another season of. Okay, so you can also even edit it. So there's a decent amount you can edit on here. You can edit who's baby faces, who's heels, and you can go to Raw and do the same thing. We're just going to leave it as is, just default first year. But now we got to decide who we want to play as. You can also pick if you want to play as, you know, you can pick the original overall. Or you can do a season. Overall, you start out higher, but I believe you can't change it. You're just, that's it for the whole season. Season, you start at a low 10 for everyone. 10 overall, like terrible. Like, you're probably going to lose a few matches there at the beginning, unless you're just really good. But you can upgrade it with points and get it all the way up. You can max out all your stuff at the end. We're just going to do, if we're doing a creative superstar, you have to start out on that 10. Which I think is a neat idea. I think that's kind of fun. But like, if you're someone like The Rock, like, why would you want to? I guess it'd be interesting. But we're not going to play as someone too crazy overpowered. I'm not going to be playing as The Rock, Goldberg, Brock, Rey Mysterio. No, I don't want to start out as a champ. You got Randy Orton, Matt Hardy, Kurt Angle. I thought about John Cena, Dr. Thuganomics. He's not too high in this game. He's actually a 75. The Hurricane, maybe. That's some Edge. Edge is not anything insane in this game. Eddie Guerrero, rip Eddie, man. Christian. Chris Jericho. Let's see. I'm honestly leaning towards Steve Austin, 85. That feels low for him, man. Yeah, heck, 80 for Shawn Michaels feels a little bit low. I don't like that. But also, I got to think about the brand I want to be on, Raw or SmackDown, because both of these brands had their A game this year in 03. Gosh, there's just, I feel like there's not a wrong choice. I mean, maybe if I went as, like, Rico, that would be a wrong choice. I'm leaning towards, part of me thought about HBK, part of me's thinking maybe Edge. And then Chris Jericho, any of those three guys. But they're all on Raw, so I guess either way I'm going to be on Raw. But you know I like playing as a good heel. Actually, no, Edge is on SmackDown. 79. Who's got the highest out of those? Chris Jericho is the highest, 85. He's ranked the same as Steve Austin. Gosh, I feel bad because this video has gone on for a while. I'm just so indecisive, you guys should know. Gosh. I'm going to play as, who had the better year in 03? Edge was all right, but, Chris Jericho. I think HBK, did he win it? No, he didn't. Screw it. I'll play as the sexy boy. Man, I know I won't regret any choice, but it's like, oh, man, it would have been more fun to play as a... Those are one question people always ask me. Why do you wrestle? I ask myself the same question every morning, feeling the pain. But I do it for so many reasons. The rush of adrenaline, the roar of the crowd, the glory of the championship. But I know there is more to it. Maybe I'm doing this to find an answer. Maybe when I get to the top of this squared circle, I'll find out something about myself. Maybe I won't find out anything. But I guess I'll step into that ring again tonight. Because I know the view from in there is unbelievable. Nice. It's like him talking to himself, I guess. You get that no matter who you play. WrestleMania was a huge success, but the dust has not settled just yet. That main event was awesome. I think the fans had trouble sleeping last night. Then we should apologize ahead of time. You might have trouble sleeping tonight as well. By God. The same. Hopefully I don't all things are possible. I like that shirt. Hey, HBK. As you probably know, I'm the GM of Raw. This is Eric Bischoff. And as a GM, I have a certain duty to provide the best quality show to the fans. But you're a smart guy, so I don't need to explain this to you. Don't let the pressure get to you. And welcome to Monday Night Raw. Yeah, the music, moving to the music, yeah. Also had the better of the themes, in my opinion. Alright, also, it's a little loud for me. I might turn it down a little bit, I don't know. So you can actually add stables mid-season, edit, create, faction. This will come in play later on. Profile, you can look at superstar stats. You can look at everyone, so you can look at ours. Status is like if they have a title, how many superstar points they have. I think that's just the overall. I don't think they can. Yeah, you can't edit. You can look at everything from gender, as if there's a question about that. Classifications. So he's actually a light heavyweight. Oh shoot, I didn't even think about it. His partner is Kevin Nash. I hope I don't get a bunch of tag team matches with Kevin Nash. Shoot, okay, whatever. Maybe we can break out on Kevin Nash. Well, yeah. Face or heel, obviously we're babyface. I don't know if HBK's... Well, I guess maybe if you count DX, he could have been a heel. But even then, he was probably cheered. You can look at win-lose. So you can look at, like, every type of match type and every type of fall type, like how you lost or how you won, and your average, which I think is cool. Some top opponents, like who you've, like, you can look at, actually you can look at everyone and see like how you match up against them, and then belts, like how many runs you've had, and then your history, so you can look at like your last 200 matches. So it definitely plans on you doing more than one season, because it's got a lot on there and you can carry stuff over, so that's kind of fun. And I don't think it makes you play as the same character. Attributes. I don't think you can edit it, because yeah, it's just default. Shop zone, this is how you unlock things. I guess this is just, yeah, this is just so you can get move sets here, you can get legendary characters, you can get different arenas, which definitely, like, these are fun, like the arenas in here, the backstage ones. You can freaking wrestle in Times Square. This game was crazy. Different, there's tires, there's a bunch of different attires, bra and panties if you're into that, man. Different diva loading screens, I guess, and that seems to be it. Yep, and then finally you can start the event, move, you can actually go to different areas. So this looks like there's five different areas. GM, you can always talk to the GM. That's if you want to challenge for a title. You have to have a certain amount of superstar points. What do you want? So we can request a show transfer. We can go to SmackDown. We can check our points. Hang on, let me check. 80. Anything else I can do? So we can request a title shot. So we can challenge for any of these, actually. We can challenge. Okay, so we can't challenge for the main title. We go for the hardcore title, intercontinental title, or the world title. I don't want to go for that because then we'll get a bunch of those matches. You know what? Let's work our way up. I don't want to start too hot. Let's go for the hardcore title. Yeah, an exciting match. Okay, so we're going to get the challenge for the hardcore title tonight against RVD. That's pretty sick. Can you imagine HBK is a hardcore champ? Oh, okay, that changed. It was Steve Austin, so I guess now we're talking to Booker T. Arena back entrance. Hey, HBK. What's up, dog? Show me your little spinneroony. Do you want to form a tag team? No, I don't want to form a tag team with Booker T, so let's see the little spinneroony. Tell me you didn't just say that. Don't insult Booker T, dog. You should know Booker T is the five-time champion. Talking is over. You dig? Okay, he just left. Sucka! Oh, gosh. He called us a sucka. That's not very nice. You got dissed by Booker T, SP1. Yeah, so you can lose or gain superstar points. Sometimes doing that, going backstage places, you can start fights. If you win fights and knock them out, you get an extra point. You can ask to form tag teams. Sometimes if things go good, you know, if like you earn the respect by talking to them or something like that, you can get a superstar point. So it's us versus Rob Van Dam in the opener. Goldberg and The Rock. Oh, gosh. Steve Austin, Triple H. This is a pretty loaded card right here. And if we win, we get 1,500. DQ is off. Of course, because it's a hardcore match. I also will say, because I'm playing this on an emulator, it does have an issue every now and then. The loading screens sometimes are weird at the bottom. And sometimes they flash at the end. And then I've noticed that sometimes the loading screens, I guess we might just have time for one match tonight. Or tonight, today. I was thinking of tonight, like, in-game. I'm just a sexy boy. Sexy boy. I'm not your boy, toy. I'm just a sexy boy. I'm not your boy, toy. I'll make him hot. I make him shiver. Then he's get weak. Whenever I'm around, they see me walk. They hear me talk. Alright. But this isn't the good RVD theme. I've never been a fan of this one. I like the play the game. Play the game. Alright, yes, I'll see it. Okay. You didn't see that right there, but I'm just going to black it out for like a second. But there's a flashing screen on the loading. Okay, so I can still move with... Okay, I can still move with this. So this is it. Why does he... He starts out with a SmackDown move already? Maybe because he's champ? I don't know. So it looks like... Oh gosh, he got me. Yeah, I might not be good here at the beginning. Oh, gosh. Let's see. Oh, yeah. Ooh. A is to strike. Although, he's bodying me right now. He already got a 2 count off of that. I'm using my Xbox remote. X is to attack. Triangle is to run. And if you use circle, you can grab. That's like a grapple. And then you can do different things off of that. Boom. 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 Alright, now we're stringing something together. Oh. Okay. I know the two triggers are the reversals, but I don't remember which ones reverse which moves. I can't let him body me like that. Okay, so the right trigger... square is to get out of the ring. I'm gonna get a weapon. Let's make this a hardcore match. Oh, okay, okay. Come on. I think you can. Oh gosh. You can also throw it if you press circle. I'm just gonna keep beating him with the chair. I mean, this is a hardcore matchup. Oh my gosh! A chair DDT. And he no-sold that. He got up fairly quickly. Oh no, the ref's in it. Oh gosh. Sorry, ref. Oh gosh. Ow. Oh gosh. Okay, so alright, I have my SmackDown. Oh gosh. No. Oh, sweet chin music. Okay, I forgot how to pin. I think it's down. Yeah, it's down and... Okay, you just press down in circles. It's like a down grapple when they're laying on the ground. Oh, that was it? That was easy. There we go. HBK, the sexy boy. The Heartbreak Kid is your new hardcore champ. I can't say that I've ever seen that before. But it looks good. Looks good, champ. The only thing is, I don't know if you can challenge for multiple titles, so if we decide we want to challenge for the Intercontinental and move up, we might have to drop. I think you can have a singles and a double, like a tag title. I don't know why I called it a double. A double title. You can play the other matches, and you can watch them, but we're not going to do that. We're just going to skip them. And there can be nights where you're actually not on the card. You just skip. So we won the match. That's plus one. Plus it was a championship match. So you get two. So then you get normal like superstar points. You get plus one for every... you get plus one for every match you win and minus one for every one you lose. If you're a champ, you can have the opportunity for a plus two. Then same thing for the champion. You get more money in championship matches. And when winning as a champion, you also get even more money at pay-per-views. So all three of those things can add up to a lot of money. And experience points you can get for upgrades. I think those can also be carried over. Like, even if you don't use them one season, you can save them and maybe use them for another superstar. Like, the next season. I'm not sure on that, though. So, and I also like how it says, like, April 2nd week, Phoenix, Arizona, so that's kind of cool. There's just so many little details that they did right in this one to make it realistic. It's still really arcadey, but also somehow, like, realistic. So, I don't know. But it's really cool. I know this was kind of only one match, but it took me a while to intro into that and get it set up and set everything up, and even though we did default and to pick a character. So, again, this has been Quickie Nog on NoggTV. We're playing SmackDown Here Comes the Pain. I almost said SmackDown versus Raw. SmackDown Here Comes the Pain for the PS2, the 03 classic. Freaking awesome game. Thank you guys for watching. If you're a WWE fan, if you're a wrestling fan, AEW fan, I don't care. If you're any wrestling fan, tune in and watch this every week if you can. It's going to be every Friday. So I'm freaking excited for this. Really appreciate your time. Please like the video, subscribe. If you got other friends, share with your friends, share with everybody, man. And hit the bell icon and, you know, get notified for them. So anyways, peace out, guys. Have a good time.